MuseScore 4.3 is here, and with this release, our popular desktop notation app, used by millions of musicians all over the world, now has a new name, MuseScore Studio. So why did we change the name? MuseScore Studio reflects the app's growing capacity to support a complete suite of notation-centered music writing tools, including powerful playback features and helpful integrations for score sharing and collaboration. It'll also make it much easier to distinguish between the desktop app and the MuseScore sheet music collection available on web and mobile. So what can you look forward to in MuseScore 4.3? This update includes smart new features that massively enhance the capabilities of Muse Sounds, our flagship audio sample library. If you aren't already using Muse Sounds, get them for free by downloading the Muse Hub from musehub.com. Alternatively, the Hub will download automatically when you download MuseScore Studio from this button on our website, musescore.org. Once you have Muse Sounds installed, then the next time you add stave text to an instrument, you'll see this little audio icon appear. Click on the icon to see options for modifying the instrument's sound. These options will vary depending on whatever you have selected for that instrument in the mixer. For example, you can now hear the effect of different implements on percussion instruments. You can choose between hard mallets for this vibraphone, or soft mallets. This cymbal can be played with large mallets, soft mallets, sticks of different sizes, and it can also be set to secco or choked. String instruments can be played espressivo, without vibrato, with regular or Bartok pizzicato, and col legno with the stick of the bow. Choral voices can sound with different phonemes, like R and M. And the harp can be heard in the regular plucking position, as well as près de la table, or near to the soundboard. Besides these, there's a wealth of other sound modifications to discover across the entire Muse Sounds library of instruments. As you might have noticed, whenever you make a selection, the stave text updates automatically. If you want to customize the text instruction, simply double-click to edit it as you normally would. It's worth noting that the audio icon next to the stave text won't appear on printed scores or those uploaded to musescore.com. It's also worth noting that this feature currently only works with Muse Sounds instruments. It'll also help support additional libraries making their way to Muse Hub in the near future. Besides this, we've enhanced the workflow between MuseScore Studio and our online sheet music and cloud storage website, musescore.com. You can now access earlier versions of your scores with our new versioning feature. Simply click this three-dot menu button and choose See Version History, where you can download earlier versions, add notes to help you remember what's different about a version, and even restore an earlier version so it can be viewed by others. There's also a new way to share scores with others. You can now invite people to view your private or unlisted scores so they can give feedback on your works in progress, significantly streamlining collaboration between composers and performers. MuseScore Studio 4.3 also includes some helpful engraving and interaction improvements. There are now more options for tied notes in tablature, allowing you to show or hide repeat fret numbers and control where parentheses get used. You'll also have more control over where clefs appear in your score, with new options to hide them after their first appearance, a style frequently used in jazz and contemporary guitar scores. While we've been preparing this release, our team has also been hard at work on the next version of MuseScore Studio, which will come out later this year and already promises massive new features and enhancements, including some long-awaited good news for percussionists. To make sure you don't miss out on information about future releases, be sure to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching and take care.